Feels pretty good, actually. Yeah. Couple little, like, when I was doing a couple turns, it was kind of a little bit sore. Couple upshifts here and there. But it's still healing, you know, it's still healing pretty good. It's been 6 months, and supposed to be like, with the total knee replacement, it's supposed to be like probably a year to heal completely. So anyways, I'm doing pretty good. I've been waiting for this day. It's been, you know, like I said, it's been 6 months, and been waiting for this day to get out here on the track. And it was a great day riding, for sure. So I tore my ACL in 1990. That's how long ago it was. So, you know, it was one of those things that I was just about to make it. Didn't have time to, you know, I didn't have a 6 month window to kind of get my knee fixed. So my ACL was kind of, you know, it was really secondary. I wasn't thinking about it too much. I did some rehab and then just on with racing I went. Thank goodness for CTI braces. I wore those my whole career, and it pretty much saved my knee. But, you know, after 20 years of having no ACL, my leg started to pronate, which means the lower leg started to go out. It was 11 degrees out, started smashing my meniscus. I had two surgeries here, started building up a bunch of arthritis here. So basically, when I was done racing my career, my knees started getting pretty bad. And then I held off for about another 8 or so years, or maybe 10. And I guess finally for me, what was the straw that broke the camel's back for the surgery part of it was I just couldn't run with my kids, couldn't play any basketball with them, was having a hard time playing any tennis with my wife, and like only thing I could do was ride my bicycle. So I don't know, it was like, okay, cool, it's time, we got to get it done. And so yeah, here we are 6 months later and feeling pretty good. I think if it keeps on this trajectory, I think I'll be stoked I did it. For a while I wasn't that stoked. This thing hurt a lot. I mean, I think I'm pretty tough, but this thing hurt. I mean, I was crying like 2-3 weeks into it. At night when I go to sleep, I was crying. And of course I was trying to get off the pain pills because I don't like those things. So I tried getting off them a little bit too early, and then I was, oh man, that was a bad thing. So then I had to get back on them for another couple days. But finally got to a point where I could survive through the night without, you know, dying. So anyways, it's been an uphill battle, but it was a good day. Good day to get on the bike again. You know what? It's fun. I mean, I've never really been off my bike for 6 months ever, since I was probably 14 years old. So, you know what? I mean, on one hand, for a while, it was kind of refreshing. But I mean, I love my dirt bike so much. It was like, I just couldn't wait to get back on it. But in the meantime, I got to do cool stuff. Like, you know, Kawasaki came out with a new KRX 1000, and we built up a car, and I raced King of the Hammers, or competed in King of the Hammers, and what a cool event. I mean, that was such a rad event. I've been racing off-road, as you guys probably know, for the last, you know, whatever, eight or nine years, so ended up stopping racing for the championship anyway. Raced a couple races last year, but it was time to just do other events, and King of the Hammers was one of them. So anyways, yeah, it was a good time. You know, I got to spend a lot of time with my kids, and was off my bicycle, was off my motorcycle. I ate a lot, which is probably, you know, that part's the downside. Gained a couple pounds, but anyways, I'm back to being active now, so summer's coming. Should be a fun summer.